If you're watching this, I'm going to assume that you are an artist, whether it's just as a hobby, or maybe you're already trying to make a living as an artist. And I'm sure if that's the case, you've dreamed about what it might be like to be a successful artist, right? The idea, maybe you've dreamed of like having an opening at a show with galleries full of people who just love your work. Maybe there's a waiter walking around with drinks, live music playing, and red dots are going up all over the place as paintings are selling. Or maybe you dream of having an online sale. You know, maybe like, what if I could have a sale in one day and like sell $40,000 worth of work or something like that? Or maybe it's not about kind of any of those big things. Maybe it's just about making a decent living as an artist. You know, maybe you want to make $50,000, $100,000. $200,000, maybe $250,000. Whatever your dreams are, those are shared by many, many other people. But there's a big problem, right? The problem is, how do you get there? And first of all, is it even possible? So a recent survey in the United States, it showed that 80% of full-time artists claimed earnings of less than $10,000 per year. And half of those had earnings of less than $5,000 a year. And that's out of 200,000 people who were self-professed full-time artists. So the stereotype of the starving artist is certainly alive and well. Now, there was a time in my life where I was exactly in those shoes. I'd graduated from art college. I've spent 2 years as a starving artist. And then I just came to the realization that I just was not talented enough to make a living as an artist. So I actually gave up on the dream. The Toronto Police Force was hiring. So I joined the Toronto Police Force and decided it was time to just try Plan B. And I did that for almost 18 years. But in the late 90s, there was something that happened that really changed my life. A good friend of mine, a police officer, he was murdered on the job. And that really, really shook me, because my plan had always been that, you know, I'll do my 30, 35 years in the police force. Once I retire, then maybe I could get serious about my art again, just as kind of a hobby. And when Billy was killed, it just really, really reminded me of my own mortality. And it just reminded me that, you know, there's no guarantee of this time down the road. So the thing is, I was working on the police force, but I was an artist. I knew inside I was an artist. The problem was, I wasn't actually making any art. I knew I was an artist inside. I just knew that was a part of who I was, but I wasn't drawing, I wasn't painting, and nobody else even knew that I was an artist. All they knew me as was a police officer. So I decided it was time to get serious about my art. So I started reading books, and I started making it a practice to paint or draw, you know, as much as I could. And a funny thing happened. I actually got better and better and better. I was elected as a member of the Canadian Society of Painters and Watercolor. I was elected as a senior signature member of the Canadian Institute of Portrait Artists. I started getting some commissions, to the point where I thought, you know what, I'm going to give this another try. So in 2000, at the age of 39, with two small boys at home, I quit my job. I walked away from my pension and I started my life as a full-time artist. And it is still to this day the scariest thing I've ever done in my life. Well, it was not an immediate success. For the first 5 years, I struggled along. I really had no idea of how to make a living as an artist. And I never made more than $20,000 a year in those first 5 years. And there was a couple of years where I made like $12,000 or $13,000. And the main problem was that I knew nothing about the business of being an artist. But luckily, because I was a member of the Canadian Society of Painters and Watercolor, I got to know some other successful artists through picking their brains, being a voracious reader. I started to realize that there were certain key strategies that were consistent with people who were successful. And I started putting those into play. And once that happened, then my career really took off. I ended up having success beyond my wildest dreams. So all of those things I talked about at the start of the show, that gallery opening with, you know, it was actually lined up outside the gallery. When it opened, people rushed in. Red stickers started going up everywhere. There was waiters walking around serving wine. Someone was playing live music. Now, that was about 10 years ago. And that was actually at the end of that show, or during that show, is when I realized I was going to make over $200,000 that year. I've actually made over $200,000 every year in the last 10 years. And I've had a couple of years where I hit over $250,000 in earnings from my art. Now, how did I do that? And more importantly, is it possible that you can do that? And the answer is yes, because I'm not special. I always thought when I saw people who were hugely successful that they had some gift, some special talent that had been anointed on them. And that was not the case for me. And in case you're thinking, well, yeah, everybody that's successful says that. How do we know that these strategies that you've come up with actually work? Well, let me tell you. In 2017, I had the opportunity to mentor a young artist by the name of Brooke Cormier. Now, this happened just totally accidentally. Her dad was a friend of mine. She'd gotten to know me, and she was interested in art. She was a hobbyist painter who was pretty good, but, you know, certainly not gifted. And she had no formal art training. In fact, she just graduated as a landscape architect from Guelph University in Ontario. And then she broke the news to her parents that she really didn't want to be an architect. Thank you so much for this wonderful education, but I want to be an artist. And the first I heard about this was when her dad told me this on the golf course, and he was not happy with me because he looked at me and my influence as being the main reason that his daughter was going to throw her life away and pursue a life of an artist starving in a garret. And so I said to him, I said, I think she should do this. She's young. Even if it doesn't work out, she can always go back to the landscape architecture. And I said, you know what? If it'll make you feel any better, how about I mentor her? I'd be willing to meet with her on a regular basis and mentor her as long as she was willing to have our sessions filmed. And then I could put them up on my YouTube channel. So he spoke to her and we agreed to do that. And so Brooke and I started meeting on a regular basis in 2017. And you can actually see all of those sessions on my channel. It's under the mentorship project. Well, putting my advice into play, Brooke was able to earn over $30,000 in her first year pursuing art full time. Remember, it took me 6 years until I was able to earn $30,000. And we're now not quite 5 years later, and her work sells for the same amount as my work. She's got over 250,000 followers on social media, and she ships and sells her paintings and her prints around the world, and she is just living the life of her dreams. So the big question now is, could you put these strategies into play and potentially live the life of your dreams, the life of a successful artist? Well, I believe the answer is yes. If you have a passion for art, if you have a solid work ethic, and you have a willingness and ability to learn, if you're willing to do the work, then I think that achieving a success as an artist to the point where you can earn a decent living is not only possible, but it's actually highly probable. Now, I'm doing a live webinar on Saturday, March 19th at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time, where I'm going to give a presentation called The Business of Being an Artist. Now, there's a 3-hour presentation followed by Q&A. And the last time I did this, the live Q&A went for over 3 hours, and I will stay until every question has been answered. Now, I have a ton of content up on YouTube. I have probably over 200 videos now and probably close to 200 hours of content, all directed at helping aspiring artists achieve their dreams. And there's certainly nothing wrong with sifting through all that content and taking out the parts that are relevant to you and trying to put a plan together. But if you don't have the time for that, or you don't want to do that, this is the opportunity to take what I think are the key elements, the key strategies that you need, regardless of whatever stage you're at right now in your career, and take these and put them in place to move your art forward and move your career forward. And you'll also have access to the replay of the webinar that you'll have available for lifetime. So you can go and you can watch it as many times as possible as you want. You can watch it over and over again. You can come back next year, 2 years, 3 years. Now, this is not a plan of everybody do this, this, and this, because everyone's going to be at a different stage in their career, different stage in their development, and potentially different in terms of what they want out of an art career. So this is not that. What this is going to provide you a compass so that you can actually create your own plan for wherever you are right now to help you achieve your dreams and what you think of as success. Now, how much am I going to charge for this, right? That's the one thing everybody wants to know is how much is this going to cost me? Well, the answer is not very much. Let me put it into perspective. I have a mastermind course that I teach that is like many, many hours of courses, as well as a membership in my Hungry Artist community. That's a community where we get together every few weeks on Zoom calls. I will critique members' work. I'll offer coaching sessions and I'll just do general Q&A. And then the artists also have the opportunity to use each other as a resource. The whole idea is to build a community of other artists who share the same vision, share that same passion, and can help each other along the way. Well, that big course, Becoming a Successful Artist, that's actually a bundle of all of my courses. If you were to buy each of those courses individually, that would be $1,600. You can get the whole bundle on my website, all of it together wrapped up for $995. But even that's a lot of money. And I realize that, especially if you're a starving artist, probably that's outside of the realm of what you want to spend, especially when you don't even know if you're going to get results, right? So the regular price for this webinar, where you can get all of my best advice and enough to actually launch you on your journey, potentially achieve your dreams, the regular price of that is $89. And the last time that I held this webinar, that was the price that I charged for everyone, and it filled up very quickly. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make it even better. I'm going to lower the price to $69 for those of you who sign up prior to March 12th. So if you act now, you can not only guarantee your spot, because once the course fills, that's it, but you can save $20 and get it for $69 right now. Like I say, that's a 3-hour presentation, Q&A, which will likely be 3 hours. It also is available for you to rewatch, but not only that, for those of you who are thinking that, gee, you might be interested at one point in joining my mastermind or finding out what that's all about, after you watch the webinar, if you're interested in going to the Becoming a Successful Artist course, it's going to be made available to you at an amazing discount. You're also going to get the first year of the Hungry Artist community half price after the three months free. And you'll be able to put the $69 cost of the webinar towards that course. And if you take the webinar and you don't think you got $69 worth of value out of it, I'll be happy to refund your money within 24 hours of the webinar. I know I'm going to give you way, way, way more value than what I'm charging you for. And hopefully I'm actually going to be able to change some of your lives. Now, for those of you who don't know me or know kind of much about me, in 2019, I had what I call the year of the thyroid from hell, and I almost died twice. And actually, during that time, I came to the realization that I had really accomplished everything that I wanted as an artist, way, way, way beyond my wildest dreams. And one of the things that I was most proud of was the fact that I'd been able to help coach Brooke and help her to achieve the life of her dreams as well. And I really decided that if I came out of my illness and I got healthy again, I was actually going to change my mission from just painting in my studio and selling my work to doing everything I could to help other artists achieve their dreams. And the only way that I could see that I could actually do that and do it well was to be able to do it full time. And the only way I could do that was if I was to create a successful business of teaching artists of how to become successful artists. So in December of 2020, I launched the Tim Packer Art Academy online, and I've had a number of people take courses there. We've sold over 100 of my masterminds, and we've sold over 600 of my mini courses, and the response has been overwhelmingly positive. And again, the one thing I just want to say is being successful as an artist, becoming a successful artist, is not about some gift. It's not about being talented that you're born with. Talent is not something you're given. Talent is something you acquire over hundreds and hundreds or even thousands of hours of diligent effort over time. And it's just the sum total of skills, knowledge, competencies, technical ability and creativity, experience that you've amassed over your lifetime. So when I gave up the dream at 21 years of age because I believed I wasn't talented enough, I was actually 100% right. If I'd only added the word yet at the end of it, I wasn't talented enough yet. through a lot of work, I became much more talented. And then, as I say, I've gone on to have a life in art that just exceeded my dreams by a large margin. Now, I'm actually currently working on a book telling my story, telling my journey that I hope will help encourage other artists. And I've actually just been recently speaking with an editor, and what we've decided is that there's been a number of life-changing moments in my life where I've had a conversation or I've had an experience that just put a little bell on, and it had a change in the direction that all of these little changes led to the success that I've had. I really believe that for some of you out there watching, maybe you, this could be one of those life-changing moments. This could be taking the step to watch this webinar, could be the thing that launches you towards living the life that you really know deep down inside you should be living. And it's $69, right? And it's a money-back guarantee. And so what do you have to lose except potentially the rest of your life doing something you really don't love doing and wishing that you could be doing what you really love? So the next 5 years of your life are going to go by one way or the other. You're either going to sit there 5 years from now and go, wow, I can't believe it. I've accomplished what I wanted, or I'm much closer to that. Or you could be sitting there just like you are now saying, gee, wouldn't it be wonderful if I could do what he's doing, what she's doing? And the question I have for you is, why not you? Why not now? So I hope to see you on Saturday, March 19th, live webinar on the business of being an artist. Okay, I just realized I forgot to tell you how you go about signing up for the webinar. So that's not really good for any sort of business. So if you're interested in taking the webinar, there's a few ways you can access it. I provided a link down in the description. So if you click on that link, that will take you to the registration page. And again, $69 only until March 12th. Between March 12th and the 19th, it will be raised to $89. You can also go to www.timpackerartacademy.com. Go to the homepage there, and there will be a link there to take you to the registration page. And then a number of you might be watching this video because you're on my newsletter from the Tim Packer Art Academy. If that's the case, you'll find a link right in that newsletter that will take you to the registration page. Now, there are a limited number of spots available for the webinar. I only have so many available on my Zoom plan. And again, once it's filled up, that's it. There will be no more. So I really encourage you that if you want to get it at the $69 price and you want to make sure you get your spot, I would register sooner rather than later.